When you need to learn something quickly, maybe to find out when a celebrity was born, or what country has the most people, where do you usually go? If you said Google, you're not alone. Most of us go straight to Google or a similar search engine to find this information. Google is easy to use because we can talk to it using something called natural language. Natural language is the way we talk to our friends and family. It's the way we post to social media, and it's the way you're probably used to finding information. When you use a search engine like Google, you can put in a whole sentence just like you would say out loud to a friend. For example, I could go to Google and type in, "Why aren't there more women studying science?" And I'll get results. That's one of the nice things about Google. It's very easy to talk to. However, one of the problems with Google is the quality of the information. You can find some good resources on Google, but you're also going to find a lot of junk. You might find people trying to sell you stuff, their personal blogs, even social media posts. So while Google is easy to talk to, it's a lot harder to find reliable information. For the library databases, the opposite is true. The databases have been carefully curated by information experts, your librarians, and you can easily limit to peer-reviewed scholarly articles to make sure you're finding reliable sources. So the databases have good information, but they're not as easy to talk to. That's because you can't talk to the databases using natural language. Instead, you have to speak to them using the language of keywords and search terms. If I go to OneSearch and I type in the same natural language sentence, "Why aren't there more women studying science?" I'm going to get no results, or I'm going to get results that have nothing to do with my topic. This happens to students all the time. They go to the library databases, type in their thesis statements, and get no results. Then they look at their librarian and say, "There's nothing on my topic." The truth is, there's plenty of information on the topic. The students just are not speaking the language of keywords and search terms, so the database doesn't understand what they're asking. To talk to the databases, you have to identify your topic's keywords, which are the words that represent the most important concepts, which can then help you figure out what search terms to put in those search boxes. So how do you find your keywords? Find out in the next section, when you watch the video from the drawing board to the search box. And remember, if you have any questions, contact your friendly librarians at the Marks Library.